Welcome to the Microsoft Azure Data Self-Help Series. My name is Kenny Yu, and today I'll be presenting on configuring SQL Server Always On for Azure VM. In this session, I'll be sharing with you best practices for SQL Server Always On for Azure VM and common errors we see. When configuring SQL Server Always On for Azure VM, there are four methods to choose from, each offering a different level of user involvement. The table below lists the options in ascending order from least to greatest number of steps required configuring SQL Server Always On for Azure VM. It is recommended that users utilize the Azure portal as it is the most user-friendly and efficient method. During this session, I will be demonstrating a quick demo of how to configure SQL Server Always On using the Azure portal. However, if the Azure portal does not meet your specific requirements, manual deployment may be necessary. It is essential to review the prerequisites for each option to avoid any deployment errors such as cluster configuration, load balancer, AD permissions, and networking. To deploy Azure using the portal, it is essential to note that a domain controller and a domain account are required when utilizing the high visibility marketplace image. To begin the deployment process, navigate to the search bar and enter Azure SQL. Next, select SQL Server Virtual Machines, and to deploy a multi-subnet always on, ensure the high availability checkbox is selected. After selecting the preferred SQL Server license, click Create, then provide the details such as resource group, name, region, availability, options, image size, username, password, and public inbound ports. Next, provide a cluster name and a storage account followed by entering domain username and credentials, finally specifying the AG group name and listener. Once all required fields are filled, then review and create the deployment. In the event of an error during deployment, it is recommended to revisit the preceding steps to locate where the error occurred. It is common to encounter errors during deployment, and one such issue is when the ADA user account lacks the necessary permissions to create a cluster. To address this error, it is essential to ensure that the account has the required permissions, which are listed in the screenshot below. By granting the necessary permissions to the ADA user account, we can avoid this error and successfully create the cluster. Another common error that we might encounter during the deployment is error 4131. This error occurs when the NT authority / system account is missing from the SQL Server. To resolve this, it is crucial to ensure that the NT authority / system account is added to all AG nodes. Ensuring that the ports required for SQL Server Always On availability groups are not blocked is another crucial consideration during deployment. These ports must not be blocked in firewall, NSG, or OS, and should not be in use by any other SQL Server instance or application in any of the AG nodes. Below is a list of the required ports that must be open for the nodes to communicate with each other. By checking and ensuring that these ports are open, we can avoid issues and ensure successful communication between the nodes. Finally, it is crucial to note that if there is more than one node per subnet, it is necessary to configure an Azure load balancer and probe port for the Azure SQL Server Availability Group VNN listener. This configuration is essential to ensure that the listener is accessible and can redirect traffic to the appropriate node. However, we can eliminate the need for a load balancer if we are using a distributed network name. In this video, we cover how to configure SQL Server Always On for Azure VM and common errors when deploying Azure SQL VM. Please visit our websites below for more information. Thanks for watching, and we hope the information in this video has been helpful to you.